What is up, everybody? It's Benjamin from Film and Addicts, and today we're going to talk about three things to avoid if you're a beginner filmmaker. So let's get started. So these are just some things that we personally see a lot of. Now, there's many, many things that separate somebody from being a good filmmaker to an amateur filmmaker, but right now we're just going to talk about three. And the first one is everyone thinking that 4K is a must. Many people first starting out think that when they get a camera, when they buy a new camera, they have to have 4K. The image has to be like razor sharp in order for it to have like cinematic images. Ourselves included, I mean, we thought that, you know, when we were looking for a new camera, that it had to be 4K. It was the new up and coming thing to be on YouTube, to have these just razor sharp images. We were always saying like, you know, does it shoot 4K? Does it shoot slow-mo in 4K? Is it shoot 4K better than this 4K camera? So all these other things that we didn't even consider at all when we were looking for a new camera. Many filmmakers starting out, they forget or they don't realize that there's so many other factors to consider when buying a camera. Now, don't get me wrong, 4K is great. We love using 4K. We're actually shooting 4K on our GH5 right now. But that's not the only thing to look for when you're getting a new camera. So remember, whenever you're looking for a camera, just because it's 4K or shoots 4K does not necessarily mean it's the best for you. All right, so this next thing is something that we see all the time. It's overusing gimbals. When gimbals come out, new gimbals come out, whatever it is, the Ronin, the Zion Crane, whatever it is, people get really, really excited. So they get it in their hands and, you know, we love it. We get these awesome cinematic shots, but then something happens. A lot of filmmakers make the mistake of putting that camera on that gimbal and then never taking it off. And the reason that this is so dangerous is because that means that they rely heavily on that gimbal getting them every shot that they need. But in reality, if you use that gimbal all the time, then your videos will become eventually boring, they become predictable. If you're on YouTube and you're using the gimbal in every single one of your videos for every single one of your shots, they know what your video is gonna look like before they even watch it. It's like using a drone. When drones first came out, you didn't really see them that much in videos. Now you see them everywhere, they're very accessible. But sometimes you see those few people who use drones in every single shot of their video and it just becomes boring. So when you're making a film, think about the different types of shots that you need. Maybe this shot over here requires to be on a tripod and to be still. Or maybe the shot over here requires to be kind of handheld and shaky. So all those different varieties of shots will help you to create your story in a more interesting and visually pleasing way. And that will naturally give more life to your videos and your videos will never become predictable. So the last thing is, and this is something that we're all guilty of, is overcomplicating everything. So a lot of times as filmmakers, as creatives, artists, we tend to overcomplicate our stories or ideas. And a lot of times that's because we want them to be perfect. We want them, when people see them, we want them to like just blow people's minds, right? We're like, we need a five-man team. We need this equipment. We need that equipment. We have to have this layered of a story in order for this to be great. Well, a lot of times what happens is the idea or the story starts to fade and fade and fade because it's hard to have access to those things, especially if you're a beginner and you're first starting out. So instead, try to create a video that is simple. Try to make it interesting, visually appealing. Maybe just yourself or maybe you and a friend and just your camera and see what kind of stuff you can do. Test your creative abilities. Like I know that this has happened with me plenty of times. I might have come up with an idea or a story, you know, put this and this and this in it, and it's gotta be this layered or whatever it may be, and then it just fades because it takes too long or it doesn't happen. So it's always better to actually have the practice and maybe not such a complex story. So these are just a few things to remember or to avoid when you first start out making videos or if you're first starting out on YouTube. So just remember, it's all about going out, creating as much content as you can to get that practice that you need, using the tools that you have, the camera that you have at your disposal. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more videos like this, any tutorials, tips, and tricks to help you become a better filmmaker, please leave a like below and subscribe if you haven't already. So we'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, see you.